The process of learning a new software can often be tedious and time-consuming. As a beginner, we have all faced those moments when we spent hours and hours fixing something only to realize it was but a trivial mistake on our part. If only someone had told us how to avoid those mistakes beforehand, a lot of this frustration could be avoided. Today, I am going to tell you 3 Blender modeling mistakes which I wish someone had told me when I started Blender. Number 1. Having duplicate vertices. This most commonly happens when we extrude a face. I've seen so many beginners do this mistake. So generally, say when we have to do a command, say we have to move this face, right? What we will do is select the face, press G and then move the face and press left click to confirm. Similarly for rotation, we'll press R to rotate and left click to confirm, right? But say if we don't want to move the face when we press G, right, then we simply press right click and the face goes back to its original position. So, you know, we have this kind of muscle memory that tells us that if you press right click, everything goes back to normal and the command we gave earlier is just cancelled. But this isn't the same with, say, extrude. So when we try to do an extrusion, we press E to extrude it. So this goes up and when we press left click, naturally, you know, the extrusion takes place. But say similarly, now if we press E and we press right click, assuming that we don't want to do the extrusion, right? So the face would go back to original position and we will think that the command hasn't taken place. But in actuality, what you would see is the face is still here and the extrusion is still on top of it. So what this has done, Blender has created duplicate vertices in the same place. So this vertex is double, this is double, and so on. So this isn't that much of a problem, but later on, if you build on this geometry, the final geometry would give much more complex problems for you. So this needs to be fixed, right? The easy solution to this is just, you know, select all the vertices in Blender by pressing A once or twice and then just press M on your keyboard. So it would give options to merge the vertices. So merge by distance, what it does is if the vertices are very close to each other, that is they are less, there is less distance between those vertices, Blender would merge those vertices. So let's see what happens. So merging vertices by distance, Blender has merged these vertices which were double in the same place. Thus we have fixed our duplicate vertices problems. Another case in which this might happen is, say you have an object and you want to, you know, duplicate the entire object within the edit panel itself. So I select all these vertices, face or edges and press Shift D. So when I duplicate it with Shift D, it just, you know, you can just duplicate it like this. But say I press Shift D and then press right click, assuming I don't want to duplicate it, then the duplicate vertices go back to the same place, but the duplicate command itself doesn't get cancelled. So now we have all these vertices in the same place as other vertices. So you can see Blender has added these double vertices in the same place. And while if you want to achieve this result, this could be useful, but in our case, these are just unnecessary vertices. So say if I do some command on this, then it would give me such weird geometry, right? So again, the same fix to it is select all the vertices by pressing A, press M, and then merge by distance. So what this has done is, you know, removed all those duplicate vertices for us. As easy as that. Number 2. Triangular versus N-gon topology. To explain this, first of all, let me tell you what an N-gon is. So N-gon is basically any N-sided polygon where N can be any natural number from 2, 3, 4, 5. It can go on to any large number. You know, such N-gons are used to make 3D modeling easy and intuitive without thinking about the process. So first, let's start by adding an N-gon and see what an N-gon is. So in the mesh, when we go to circle and in the options for add circle, we can change the N-gon fill type to N-gon, from nothing to N-gon. By default, it's at nothing. So when you make it N-gon, it gives you options to change the number of vertices. So say I make it 3. So it's a triangle, with 4 it's a square, 5 pentagon, hexagon, and so on. So you can make this any n number of sides. So this is basically an N-gon which makes 3D modeling intuitive for us, so that we don't have to worry about what's happening in the background of the software. But the software itself, when it tries to render things out, it breaks these faces into multiple triangles so that it can calculate the normals to that, which helps it determine how the face should actually look in 3D space for rendering purposes. But N-gons make it easy for us. We don't have to think about all those things while modeling. We can have our artistic freedom, right? So the computer does it all for us. But in reality, the software still has to do all these things in the background. So say this is an 8-sided polygon. When we press Ctrl T to triangulate the faces, let's see what happens. So this is how the computer by default automatically triangulates the faces. So it will break it down into multiple triangles, which make it easy for itself to display these things. So this isn't much of an issue by itself in how it works, but one should always keep in mind that, you know, any n-gon should be divided into many triangles when the final render takes place, and the topology should be modeled that way so that the software doesn't get confused about what we do. By confusion, what I mean is, say we have a square, right? So this is a plane, and you know, all these vertices lie in the same plane, so now we have no issue currently. But say, for example, I wanted to move one of these vertices up somewhere here. So now all these vertices aren't in the same plane, and the software can't tell how exactly the plane should be, right? So it has by default made a line over here, I guess, and then split it like that. So if I say take this vertex up too, what it will do is keep these vertices down here, and it has added a parting edge here, which has, you know, made the square into two triangles by itself. And what has it done is created this geometry. But the same thing could be done in two ways. So here are two examples I have on the screen. So firstly, the way which was already done, it was along this axis. So this is a similar figure to that, in which this edge can be made similar to the one which was already done by the software. But the software could have also randomly picked this edge from this to this point and given us a topology like this. So when we actually do it randomly with n-gons, and the n-gons don't have all the vertices in the same plane, we don't have much control over how the software behaves, right? So in this case, it could have been done either way, but the software randomly selected one. So whenever possible, as a beginner, always try to make sure that all the vertices of an n-gon are in the same plane. So how to ensure this? So at least for a simple case like this, I'll select all the vertices and then press scale to scale the vertices. This would normally scale the object, right? But when I press Z now with scale, what it does is it restricts the scaling in the Z axis. And now when I press 0, what it would do is scale all the vertices to be in the same plane. So now we have a perfect n-gon which should be planar. However, say if we didn't want it to be a planar surface and wanted to keep it triangular and adjust it as per our liking. So how this could have been done is, you know, this is a 4-sided n-gon. Just go into edit mode, select the face, and then press Ctrl T to triangulate the faces. So Blender automatically splits it by one edge, and then you can just adjust however you want, and so that the software doesn't randomize it for you, you can by default model it yourself and break it down into multiple triangles. But always remember, try to keep the topology as triangular as possible, and if you have to make n-gons, keep those n-gons entirely in one plane. Do not split them across multiple planes. Number 3. Not using reference images. If you're already into Blender, this might sound obvious to you that, you know, you should always use reference images. But I have seen so many beginners not use reference images. So reference image is basically any image that you can use, you know, while modeling, so that it gives you a better idea of what your final picture is going to look like. That helps the modeling process a lot. So to add a reference image, just split your tab from here and change this 3D viewport to image editor. In the image editor, go to open and choose your reference image from here. So for example, I want to model a car. Now I'll again split this and use this second image. And for the second image, now I'll add, say, another image. So I'll delete these and go to open and say I select front view. So now I have this front view and this side view of car. Always open the side so that I can use them as a reference. In the new Blender versions, they have also added a reference image feature in the 3D viewport itself. So when you want to add, press Shift A, and in the images section, go to reference image. Over here, you can choose which image you want to add. Say I want to add this side view. So the side views, when I press 1, this is my front view. I don't want the side view to be in front view, right? So I'll rotate it by 90 degrees. So now whenever I press 3 on my keyboard, I get the side view, and the car is always like this. So based on this, say now I add the plane for this, and then I extrude the plane to get a shape like this. So say I scale it in Y. So this gives me a better idea of how my control should be while making the car. So adjusting the vertices and giving the basic rough shape becomes a lot easier if you have reference images like this. So I'll just adjust these vertices, and that would help me give a better rough geometry of how the car should be. When I finally am done with doing this, I can just go on and model the finer details too. So for example, this is a very low quality image, but I can get higher quality images and then finally model the tires, the lights and other features like the windows, mirrors, etc. Adding reference images makes your job a lot easier. If you are not using reference images, start using them right now. These were three Blender modeling mistakes which beginners often make. If you like the video, please do leave a like, it helps a lot with the YouTube algorithm. If you would like to watch any other content, please comment it down below. And if you aren't subscribed to the channel already, please do subscribe. I upload new videos every week. Thank you and have a good day.